Bit of an update. First thing, really, really cool news. Really Big Monkey, he's got a new video.
Razor sharp.
Yeah, so he hasn't been very active, but good to see him back. So here's the knife that I ruined by leaving outside. Well, so-called ruin. It looks... I love the finish on the handle a lot better now. Did a couple of coats of boiled linseed oil. I've been using that finish enough now to know that it takes it really a couple of days to dry. But the handle, it's got just a... I wouldn't say it's a glossy look, but it's got a wetter look, which I like. Feels good. And I went ahead and put the linseed oil on the knife blade. I'm not recommending linseed oil to protect a knife blade, but I just thought I would try it. I was there. I can always take it off. Probably at some later point I'll do a bluing of this surface and kind of to protect the area that I'm not sharpening, protect it from rust. Now this is a very, the linseed oil on the metal is has a lot of grip, which would make the knife not so hot for slicing wood, probably. But I want to go ahead and sharpen it. It's not real sharp now. Can't find my real good three-sided stone. And it's sharpening oil. But here is, I'm just going to use Red Devil lighter fluid on this. Well, I sure felt that linseed oil come off of the blade. This is a Dan's Whetstone Company Soft Arkansas Sharpening Stone. Got a couple of their stones. Not expensive. Next time you're ordering something from somebody, look and see if they've got a, look at their sharpening stones. Everybody should have some kind of sharpening stone. I don't remember whether I ever sharpened this knife or not. I think I did sharpen it just a little bit after I originally got it, because it seemed a little dull. And I commented in the earlier video where I cleaned it up that you get various reports from people as to how sharp these knives are. Now you've seen my whole treatment of the knife. I have no idea whether this is going to cut paper or not. So there we go. Since I rusted it, I left it in the wet sheath and got it rusty. We've cleaned it up, refinished the handle, put a protective coating on the on all the metal, and sharpened it. Of course, I've seen sharper knives, sharper knife demonstrations. I'm not a knife sharpening expert by any stretch of the imagination. But you don't have to be to get a relatively sharp knife. I suppose these whetstones are really intended to be used with mineral oil. Couldn't find any. Lighter fluid's about the closest thing that I have. I thought about using some thinner. I was a little concerned about putting that in my stone. But basically you're just adding a little bit of lubricant to the stone. This knife has a belly, a bushcrafting knife. That means that it's shaped like this, so you have to turn the knife to get all the surface of the belly. and you're trying to sharpen it, I think it's about 22 and a half degrees, which I'm just eyeballing. I don't have any equipment to tell me what 22 and a half degrees is. So, not shaving sharp. Oh, it's there. But reasonable. Have to work on that a little more. And I don't think it's ever really been sharpened properly. But I can tell you it's sharper now than it was when I bought it. And sharper now than it was before I left it in the wet sheath. This is just kind of a little bit of an update on some prior videos. I got this really cool radio. This was the radio I had as a kid that my dad bought. It's a Panasonic 2200, 8-band radio, AM, FM, and 6 shortwave bands. And I played with this thing for hours, tuning around on the shortwave bands, trying to find foreign radio stations. It was endless fun for a young kid. Now, I'm not going to tune in. It might be hard to tune in a very strong signal right now because the antenna is broken. So one of the things I'm going to do to restore this radio is find another antenna. But this is supposed to be the best analog radio the Panasonic ever made. These sell on eBay in good condition for about $200. Can you believe that? And this radio's, it's got to be 35 years old. It's got to be that or more. So I've had a little interest in shortwave. So now I think we're on the AM band, for which it has no antenna. We're on shortwave radio, now we're on AM. We'll have to get in there with some pot cleaner and clean up the pots. This radio is probably older than most of your people's children. So it's going to need a little bit of attention to be a good new radio again. And if I remember, I'll do a little update video on this after I work on it. Oh yeah, it's got a light. That sounded like rap. I had to change it before I found out for sure that it was. So we've got a few little things to do. Doesn't seem like much, but it's a thing from my past that I'm really going to enjoy messing around with. Especially in the shortwave realm of things. But it doesn't receive any signals in shortwave right now. Like I say, that's probably just the antenna. So I got to source an antenna for it. And occasionally you'll see one of these radios that's bad on eBay. Broken for some reason. And so I might just buy one of those cheaper units. Just to source the antenna, that seems like a bit far to go. But whatever it takes. Whatever it is, I can fix it. I can figure it out. I just need a few more segments of antenna. Along with a few more marbles, perhaps. So there you go. Bushmore knife is dangerous again. hard to get the inside of the blade there down in that box. I'll sharpen on it some more. I like those cool videos where the guys slice up the paper. I don't know if I can learn to do, I'm sure I can learn to do that, but I don't know how to do that just yet. Please, please, don't strike any matches. No smoking. Don't want to burn myself up here. Oh, and Robert, you're supposed to be sending me a knife and a cook set. I haven't seen that knife yet. Robert from Bluegrass Bushcraft. I've been thinking about some ideas for your knife. Oh, two in a row, look at that. Three. Oops. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Without tearing. A little bit of a tear there on the end. I guess I just need a little more working on the edge. Boy, that is sharp. Well, we'll catch y'all later. There's the Bushlore knife update. Made in El Salvador. Condor knives. It's actually about a $30 knife. Said $40 in a couple of videos. Highly recommend it. I've enjoyed having the knife. It's got a little character now that I've injured it and repaired it and sharpened it. It's not a virgin anymore. There you go. See y'all later.